What message do you want to give? So we're going to start with you retired.
Tikva, with organization.
Mrs. Breder, tell me what year you retired.
I retired in 1989.
And tell us a little more about Tikva. What do they do?
Well, then, you know, it's about the same time, the same year. We went in Adat Israel to a lecture. From Israel was here Mr. Klafter, who was the founder of an organization which helps survivors, support survivors, and sees, that they receive the treatments and the help what they need and what we earned, since I am one of them. So, but he wanted Mr. Klafter only to have here, a part of AMCHA, which will help the Israeli organizations. But we were there, quite a few survivors. Laura Shelley was there, and then was there, I can't recall the names, quite a few. Odette Meyer and Rita Cohn. And we talked to each other and we said, listen, I think so. We would have to do something here for the survivors who live here in San Francisco and the Bay Area. So we started it.
And how is it different than what the Jewish Family Service offers?
It's entirely different. We spend our energy and I don't know the term for it, to help of the survivors. The organization which we founded wants and wanted always to be the speaker and helper and see that we are not shortcut, that we get the help that we need.
And what kind of special needs?
Psychological. We have social workers who go and visit them. We have psychologists and psychiatrists, of our list, and those are volunteers because we are organization which we need, non-profit, which we need money to do more, and it's very hard to get it. So we ourselves support that mostly this organization. We meet, before we met more often, but now, we are not getting younger. It's harder for us to meet, but at least once a month, twice a month, once in 2 months we meet. But we have now much help from the Jewish Family Service since we got a grant from the Claim Conference, and the grant says only for survivors. So they have now, we work closely with the Jewish Family Service to help the remaining survivors in anything what we could.
Have you ever gone into schools to speak, Mrs. Breder?
Since 1972, I visit schools and talk about my experience. I have hundreds and hundreds of letters, and only high schools or universities, private schools, and it has been for me really something which I wanted to do, to spread the word. What happened to us, and for the students, to what I get, when I talk to them, when they hear a real survivor speaking, they say how many films I saw and read books about it and documentation, no comparison, because they have it firsthand. And such a good response from students, which gives me some satisfaction that somehow I can do something that never ever again happened to human beings but did to us, regardless to race or religion. And I hope so it never will. My message to everyone who will see that tape would like to say, never give up, if you are in some trouble, persecuted with someone unfairly, just keep fighting it and never give up your faith. And I hope so, never ever again nobody will experience what I did. What else can I say? Be alive and kick. Keep kicking.
I want to thank you very much, Mrs. Breder, for your testimony.
It was a pleasure. Even, you know, I very often cry from deep scars in my heart. It never will go away. I breathe Auschwitz, I live with Auschwitz with the rest, for the rest of my life. Even I know I'm fortunate to be here and to be in a free country. But you know, the 20 years in communism, I always said, yuck, capitalism. I enjoy capitalism.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Breder.
This is my grandmother, paternal side, the mother of my father, and the picture was taken in 1914. In our hometown in Stropkov. This is Asher Reich, my father's grandfather, and it was taken in Stropkov, in the town where he was born in 1914. This is my father, Heinrich Chaim Reich, born in Stropkov, in the town where we lived, and the picture was taken approximately in the 30s. I don't know exact time. This is the wedding picture of Fred Breder and Libusha Reich, taken in August 1946 in Bratislava. This is a picture taken in Auschwitz in 1944, where I was assigned to work in a working unit which was called Canada, sorting belongings from people who were killed in the gas chambers of Auschwitz-Birkenau. This is a picture taken in 1956 in Auschwitz between the barrack 10-11, where the black wall was, my husband, Fred Breder, in the front, taking a riff to the wall in memory of the slaughtered people. This is the ketubah, our marriage license from August 1946, made in Košice. The photograph is taken by the Stern magazine, and it was in the German magazine when I was at the trial in Wuppertal. In the front you can see me, and in the back the man is the accused war criminal SS guard Gottfried Weise. In 1987 was the trial, and ended, he was sentenced to life in prison. Linda Breder enters the court in Wuppertal in 1987 where the accused, SS guard Gottfried Wiese, were sentenced to life in prison. In the forefront, you see me, Linda Breder, in 1987, in Düsseldorf, at the airport, and beside me is the welcome committee from the city of Wuppertal. Senators and his boat. I don't know their names anymore. This is the marriage license from my parents, which married in 1914 in my hometown in Stropkov, but it was signed some other city very close to. There are the names of my grandparents and my parents and the year when it was, when they married. This is a picture made in Los Angeles at the Simon Wiesenthal Center, where I and my sister, who is next to me, Edith Welish, and then Mrs. Zapletal, 3-year Auschwitz survivor, and Martha Weil, three years Auschwitz survivor, presented to the museum a book which called The Tragedy of Slovakian Jewry. The man standing there receiving the picture book is a representative of the Simon Wiesenthal Center in Los Angeles. I forgot the name. This is our, those are our children and grandchildren. First is Linda, my granddaughter, who is now a student in Arizona at the University of Tempe. Then is our grandson, Elliot, who attends the Hillel Brandeis School in San Francisco. Our daughter, my daughter, Dasha, and David, our son-in-law, and her husband. Together, it was made in 1996. This is our daughter-in-law, Karina, their little son, Ethan, also a student at the Hillel Brandeis in San Francisco, and our son, Paul, Pavel, or Chaim in Hebrew, made in 1996. Those three are our grandchildren, Caroline, that's our son's daughter, Stephen, also our grandson from my son, and Linda, my daughter's daughter. So all together we have five grandchildren and two great-grandchildren, which we show in the next picture. Continue. This is a family picture of the Breders. The first one is our grandson, Stephen, which is holding our great-grandson, Richard. The next is Karina, our daughter-in-law, with her little boy, Ethan, Pavel, Paul, Chaim, our son, our granddaughter, Caroline, with her daughter, Christina, my beloved husband, Fred, Friedrich, and next to him, my beautiful face, Libusha, Linda, American. Linda, my granddaughter. Elliot, my grandson, the brother and sister. Then my daughter, Dasha, and our son-in-law, her husband, David. It was made quite a while ago, maybe 8 years ago. And now you see the whole of our family, and I think so. I don't know, maybe more pictures continue, who knows?